Hello guys, I am Gustavo Polanco and welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today we will be binding our book and adding the final touch. I will show and explain to you some ways in which you can bind your book. The first thing we have to do is order the pieces of our book in the sequence we want to have it. My book, for example, has 12 pages. I will bind the first two pages with a scrap of fabric. With a pencil, I mark the area where I want the union to be. Then, I put glue and spread it carefully with a brush. I repeat the process at the bottom of the page. To show you another example, I will take two different pages and I will punch holes on the edge. You decide how many holes you want to have. Then, take short string and make knot on each hole. For better result, pour some glue on the knot and let it dry. Another way, similar to the previous one, is making a small cut on the edge of the papers. And using short pieces of ribbon to pass them through the cut. Finish it off by adding glue for better grip. And finally, I will glue together pieces of paper. Are in details and final touch. There are many different materials we can use for this step. I am cutting small pieces of different colored paper that I will use to join some strings of rope. on the rope, I will hang a paper bear that I have previously cut. To prevent the bear from sticking to the paper, I placed a piece of cardboard behind it until the bear adheres to the string. Then you can remove it. I will add some collage by tracing the shape of the window on this piece of magazine paper. And cut it out to fit the window edge. Then, using a paintbrush, I apply some glue under and over the paper for better adherence. Now I make grooves at each side of the balloon and curve a rope. Thank you. The final touch will be given by a pre-cut cardboard house. Markers are a great tool to add finishing touch, as you can write text or draw details on top of watercolor, paint, and color pencils. I am adding some details with markers of different thicknesses. You can also use color pencil if you want. One note, guys, I always try to reuse materials and resources. I save all magazines, book, or newspaper. I cut two small pieces of fabric to simulate curtains, and I drew the bar with marker. Thank you. As you may have noticed, the main character is the wooden bird dressed in a stripe. I used a thicker marker to add the stripe. Remember to wash the paintbrush every time you use it to spread glue. If you let dry, the brush will be ruined. A nice trick you can try is applying a light layer of glue on top of a piece of paper. When it's dry, it becomes transparent and leaves a semi-gloss finish. This fusion between all the materials we use on our book, paint, pencils, paper cutting, superimposed in a planned way, can achieve a very interesting and aesthetic composition. Here I am, adding some more details with markers. You can add other details like text, poetry, the day of your signature, but it is entirely your decision. And well, friends, I leave you some image of my book already finished. See you soon, guys.